Now, as we say each week, our show is all about you, and this next segment goes one step further. You help create it.
It's time for Haydo's Mailbag. Come on, Florence. Florence, come on.
We start tonight with a canine cost of living crisis.
Hey, Fago.
Andy Hamilton is not happy his dog's food is skyrocketing in price.
Why is it Took's dog food has gotten so pricey? Now, our dogs love it, but boy, has it got so expensive.
Andy says what used to be $39.99 at the warehouse rose to $45, $52, and then $66. When we had a look, it was selling at the warehouse for $60. Nestle, who make tucks, says pet ownership skyrocketed during COVID, and now there's a scramble for raw ingredients.
And what we're now seeing is new demands for the material we need, which has led to shortages of ingredients and packaging, higher prices.
They say in 2021, the price was $46. The recommended price now, $66. While the warehouse says, unlike the supermarkets, their prices are the same everywhere, and on average, their 15kg bag is the best value. And holy moly, remember Pippa's t-shirt fails expose?
20 to 30 tops coming in a week with these little holes.
Very common.
Well, Robert from Auckland reckons the problem could be carpet moth.
Male energetically beats his wings in a mating ritual before bending his abdomen inward.
They can breed and feed in your furnishings and clothes.
As soon as the larvae emerge from their shells, they crawl about hunting for food.
Check out what happened to Robert's threads. Robert thinks you can treat them with a repellent, or just put your clothes in the freezer.
Cheese slices these days.
And do you recall Abigail from Hawke's Bay and her problem with her cheese slicer?
I'm just trying to make my sandwich and they keep breaking. This one broke and now this one.
Abigail's mum sent us a gallery of broken cheese slices. Well, the mailbag lit up.
Yowzers!
Ian from Auckland recommends this slicer because it comes with spare wire, while Francis from Dannyvarick says the cheap slices last if you follow her three rules.
Rule number one, put a little bit of super glue, be very careful, in the central rivet, which I reckon is right there. Number two, always hold the slicer with both hands. Here we go, look at that. And rule three, the dishwasher is a no-no. That's Haydo's Mailbag for this week.